Hi. We use hooks every day to solve our tasks. As experience shows, each developer finds their own way of writing a component. This is especially true for the useEffect hook. And today, we'll look at some doubted uses of this hook. So, like the video, and let's go. Suppose we are writing a component that displays a list of books based on their category ID. We will store the books in the local state and display the book titles on the screen using an unordered list. Next, we need a function that will load the list of books based on the category ID. And of course, we need to call this function at some point. The best place to do this would be inside useEffect. However, the eslint plugin for hooks starts complaining and asks us to specify the loadBooks method as a dependency. Let's do that. But now eslint is complaining again, this time about the loadBooks function itself, saying that this function is created on every render, and therefore it's not a good idea to use it as a dependency for useEffect. Indeed, we can wrap the loadBooks function in useCallback, and, as per eslint's recommendation, specify the category ID as a dependency. Interestingly, eslint does not require us to add setBooks to the dependencies of useCallback. Let's see what the documentation says about it. React guarantees that setState function identity is stable and won't change on re-renders. This is why it's safe to omit from the useEffect or useCallback dependency list. In the end, the solution works as expected. When a new category ID is received in the component, the dependencies array in useCallback gets updated, a new function is stored in loadBooks, and as a result, the dependencies array in useEffect gets updated, triggering the function to load the books. We then see a new list of books corresponding to the selected category. But as you know, any piece of code can be written differently and still work the same way for the user. To evaluate which solution is better, I usually use two criteria. The first is code readability. For example, in this solution, the readability of the useEffect hook suffers. We want to call it when the category ID changes, but we end up calling it when the reference to the function changes. It sounds quite complicated. Moreover, the current idea of memorizing the function by useCallback seems dubious. We are essentially asking the function to memoize itself if the category ID doesn't change, so that later, useEffect can rely on whether this is a new reference to the function or the previous reference. In my mind, all of it looks like a mess of code. It seems like we are hostages to the technical limitations of the tool we are using. Everything should be simpler. Even the implementation with component did update, and comparing this props category ID and prep props category ID seems more readable than our written component. Oh, I almost forgot to mention the second criterion. It is the rational use of resources. As we know from the previous video, useCallback or any other hook is just a function to which we pass two parameters, the callback and the dependency list, which we have separated into two distinct variables for clarity. Next, we have another function called useEffect, to which we also pass a callback and dependencies. Thus, in terms of resource usage, we have the following picture. Two callbacks, two dependency arrays, and two hooks. It is too much for such a small task. We only need to evaluate the rationality of resource usage. We create the function and assign it to the loadBooks variable, then the virtual tree is built, after which the virtual tree updates the browser, and only then does the useEffect run where we use loadBooks. Looking at this entire chain, it seems more efficient to create the function directly before using it. As you can see, the solution is not the best by both criteria. We should do something about this. So, let's try to approach writing this component from the other side. Let's start from the point when we have a book state and the JSX of the book list. One of the wishes for readability was to write useEffect that would depend on category ID, and at the same time, would not require the loadBooks function as a dependency, which useEffect should call inside of it. The solution to this dilemma is to create the loadBooks function directly inside useEffect. Yes, you can do it this way. It does not contradict the principles of hooks. Moreover, this approach is advocated by the React documentation itself. Let's analyze the component written in this way according to all criteria. First of all, readability has improved. Indeed, useEffect depends only on category ID. We have also avoided calling the useCallback hook, which also worsened readability. Next, let's compare how many resources were consumed. There are still two callbacks because even though loadBooks is created inside useEffect, it is still created. However, the situation with dependency arrays has improved. Now there is only one dependency array. The same goes for hooks. There is only one hook left. So we saved on one array and one hook. The component's lifecycle order has also improved. We have achieved that the function will be assigned to loadBooks only after rendering in the browser, which is what we wanted to achieve earlier. Therefore, we have also improved the performance. This way of creating a function inside useEffect also has other interesting advantages. Let's consider the situation that has arisen. Let's assume that the first render of the component begins with category ID equal to 2. At this moment, the user sees an empty list of books. Then, a request load books with category ID equal to 2 is sent to the server inside useEffect. At the same time, the user decides to view another book category, and the component receives category ID equal to 3. Accordingly, a new request load books with category ID equal to 3 is sent to the server. After all this, the server responds for category ID 2, and the user sees a list of books that are no longer relevant. And then the response from the server for category ID equal to 3 immediately arrives, and the list of books displayed to the user is updated again. Agree, not the most pleasant behavior. Therefore, a quick solution could be to add the isIgnoreResponse field with an initial value of false inside the load books function before assigning the response to the setBooks method, we will check if we should ignore the response from the server. Now let's consider the place where isIgnoreResponse is changed to true. This place is the function that is passed to useEffect as return and is called whenCategoryID changes. Thus, for each category ID, its own isIgnoreResponse will be created, and through closure, we can decide whether to save the server response to the state or not. Of course, this solution looks like a kind of life hack. But with these examples, I wanted to show that we are still in the process of creating best practices for hooks, so continue to experiment. Perhaps you will find an even better solution. If you liked this video, you can give us a like, subscribe to the channel, and share this video with your colleagues. Bye.